One of the best parts about MATLAB is doing stuff with matrices. After all, that's why MATLAB was basically invented, as far as I know, is because it's awesome with matrices. And so that's what we're going to do, is play with matrices and talk about why they're amazing. So defining matrices is very straightforward in MATLAB. You can do it, if you've used the TI-89, it's just like the TI-89, but you can use it with commas and semicolons and not commas and however it is you want to do it. So if you want to create a matrix that looks like, I don't know, like 3, 4, 2, 3, or 3, 5, 2, 3. So if I want a matrix that looks like this, 2, 3, I can literally just write it like that. And there's my matrix, 3, 5, 2, 3. Thank you. Or if I want, I can make the same matrix, and I could say 3, 5, and then use a semicolon to go to the next line, 2, 3. And if I hit enter, you can see me do that. I'm going to come down here, and I'm going to type format compact, because that'll take away the extra line spaces so you can see what I'm doing a little bit better. I always like to CLC clear at the beginning, not DLD. CLC clear at the beginning. Okay, so there we go. So there's ways to do that. I can say 3, 5, 2, 3. That works. I can go 3, 5 with no comma and then 2 with a comma and 3. It's the same thing. If I want to add a row, I can do it like this, and that's fine. You can't see it anymore, but it's gone. Thank you, Windows Update. That's helpful. So I can do it like that. I can just put in another semicolon, get the same thing. I can put a semicolon and commas. I can, I don't know. I can even like just hit a new line. Instead of doing a semicolon, I can actually just put in a new line. That last one's a little funky looking, but it actually totally works. I have a 3 and a 5, so MATLAB says, okay, you got a 3, you've got a 5, semicolon, new line, okay. 2, comma, thanks for letting me know. 3, oh, new line, you must need a new line, and it goes there, and you got 9, 8. And it's beautiful, and it's amazing, and it's super, super happy. So there you go. Ways to get matrices. Let's see, what else can we do? Oh, yeah, and you can just, if you really wanted, be like, oh, these guys don't like each other, but they still turn out to be exactly the same. So that's kind of funny. It's not like it's exactly one space. You can put as many spaces as you want. And since MATLAB doesn't wrap, you can go all the way over here. And if I run it, it's still there. So that's kind of fun. Let's see what else can we do. So this is a useful, the little ellipsis. So make ellipsis. I don't know how to spell ellipsis. Oh, I have it spelled there. Ellipsis. So basically, like, say you have a lot of numbers and you're like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Well, I can't spell. 8, 9, 10. 8, 9, 10. And then you run it and you're like, yay, there are my numbers. And that's fantastic. Well, if you want to, you can also go through and you can say, well, I don't know. I guess if you get a whole lot of numbers, like, I'm going to do this multiple times, so I could have 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, thank you, that's not what I meant, and there's just a whole lot of 1 through 10s. But if I look at the code, you're like, man, that's kind of hard to see. So actually, you know what I'm going to do? That'll make it, you know, that'll be fine. I don't need to overthink this. I can go in here and I can say do, 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 and you'll see how all of a sudden the dots turn blue. Maybe you can see it, maybe you can't. But whenever I went do, 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 the dots turned blue, and if I run it again, I'm going to get the exact same thing. So basically, I'll show you that a little bit more, obviously. So whenever I go through here, do, 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 it basically goes to a new line. Not a new line, it continues on the same line, the opposite of what I said. It continues along the same line. I don't have to start it at 1. I could say 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, dot. To do space dot 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 and then 4, 5, 6 and it ba-chonk and it still works. So the ellipsis just basically means to go to a new line, and that's pretty cool because you can, you know, if it goes off, it's a really, really long line, it allows you to continue it and not have to make it look funky. This is kind of cool. You can actually create matrices in terms of other matrices. And that's actually a pretty fun thing to do. So say you've got a matrix like this. So So this is kind of a little straightforward matrix. So you've got a matrix like S equals 1 and 5. So you have S equals 1 and 5. I could actually go through and I could say, well, what if I want to create another matrix called T? I could make this one say 3, 6, say I wanted to make something that said 3, 6, 1, and 5. Okay? Well, there's a couple of ways I could do that, actually. I could just actually type in 3, 6, 1, 5, just like you would normally think. But another thing that I could do is actually I could say 3, 6, and then I could say go to the next line and then put in the S matrix. Isn't that kind of weird? So I can say 3, 6, then put in the S matrix. That's an S. Yes. If I wanted to make it say 3, 6, 1, 5, I could do that. Or I could do something, let's see. Zoom. I could also say, all right, well, so another thing I could do is I could come in here and I could say that U is equal to 3, 6, right? So I could say, make another one, so I could also say that T is equal to U, new line, S, like that. And it literally just comes through here and MATLAB says, oh, okay, I'm going to create a new matrix and I'm going to put in the U variable, all right, and then I'm going to go to the new line and then I'm going to put in the S variable and then I get that 3, 6, 1, 5 again. Which is kind of cool. Kind of cool. Let's see. What if I could say, instead of having T look like that, what if I want A to look like this? 3, 6, 1, 5. Well, I could come through and I could say, from a MATLAB perspective, I could say, ooh, wait, that's not going to do any good because you're not going to see this way. Zoom out. I could come in and I could say, all right, well, then that means that A is equal to, basically, 3, 6, this 3, 6 flipped. And do you remember how to flip matrices in MATLAB? You flip them by doing a transpose operator. So I could say transpose U, and then over, and then transpose S. Now see if that makes sense, because you say, well, why don't I have a new line character? Because if I didn't, so what this is going to do as it stands is it'll say, all right, the first thing I'm going to do in the matrix is I'm going to put in a U transpose, which is this. Then I'm going to scoot over and I'm going to put in an S transpose, which is this. If I had put in U transpose, new line, S transpose, then what it would have said is, okay, so I'm going to put in 3, 6 transpose, but then I'm going to go to the next line and I'm going to do 1 and a 5 in a transpose. So that would actually get me something looking like that. So this is just a lot of fun to play with, and you can do all kinds of little things like it. So if I have, what are the ones I had? T, let's go ahead and write these in because it's fun. So I had S was 1, 5, and I had U was 3, 6. So I could come in here, I could say, let me start with the CLC here. I could say that T is going to be, what did I say, U, new line, S. There's my 3, 6, 1, 5. I said that my A could be U prime, S prime. And then I can get my 3, 6, 1, 5. So you can really do all kinds of stuff with matrices. If I wanted, I could create a matrix where I did, what else could be silly? If I wanted to create a matrix B that looked like 3, 6, 1, 5, 3, 6. I wonder if I could do that. Let me do it this way. 3. I know what I'm doing. I got a plan. 3, 6, 1, 5, 3, 6. Okay, so this is kind of crazy. So I look through here and I think about, well, where is the shape? If I look at the shape, there's my 3, 6, that's my U. Then I have my 1, 5, that's transposed, that's my X. And then here along the bottom, I have the U again, like a normal. So that means that if I'm thinking about the way this is going to look, then I could say that that's going to be U transpose. Not a new line. U transpose, scoot over, S transpose, then a new line, and then put down a U. So I can either write it like that, where I actually put the new line character, or I could say U prime S prime and just hit the Enter key and come down here and hit U. I've got amazing handwriting. So let's try it both ways and you'll see you get the same answer. So I can say B is, what was it? I already forgot. U prime, S prime, new line, U. Or these two should be the same. These last two should be the same. U prime, S prime, and then I'll just hit Enter and say U. And so see how they turn out? Pretty cool. Makes me happy.